हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 115। ट्विटर हैज स्टार्टेड रजिस्ट्रेशन फॉर इट्स न्यू इन्फ्लुएंसर मोनेटाइजेशन फीचर्स। सुपर फॉलोअर्स अलाउज यूजर्स टू पे मनी फॉर इन्फ्लुएंसर्स फॉर एक्सक्लूसिव कंटेंट। टिकेटेड स्पेसेस अलाउ एक्सेस टू ऑडियो रूम सिमिलर टू क्लब हाउस एंड डिस्कॉर्ड। यूजर कैन यूज सुपर फॉलोअर्स टू टिप देयर फेवरेट इन्फ्लुएंसर्स लाइक $2.99, $4.99 और $9.99 पर मंथ फॉर एक्सक्लूसिव कंटेंट। इन्फ्लुएंसर्स कैन ऑल्सो चार्ज यूजर्स बिटवीन $1 एंड $9.99 फॉर एक्सेस टू सोशल ऑडियो रूम्स। विद टिकेटेड स्पेसेस यू हैव ability to set the size of your room, inviting 100 people or just 5 people. The semiconductor shortage issue has already affected various industries across the globe. Now the situation has apparently worsened as wait times for chips have hit a record high of 18 weeks. According to the report, automobile makers and consumer electronic based brand have to wait even longer for components since delays in filing orders continue to worsen. The lead times for chips, which is a gap between ordering a semiconductor and receiving the delivery, have risen from just a single week to a whopping 18 weeks back in May 2021. This is an indicator that chip makers are currently struggling to keep up with the demand. After reviewing a case filed by two lawyers against Google's anti-competitive practices in the smart TV segment, the Competition Commission of India has now ordered an investigation into this matter. While Google has denied any wrongdoing, the antitrust watchdog is convinced that a case is made up for directing an investigation based on its initial review. Apple is expected to launch new 2021 iPhones in September. The company is yet to make an official announcement on the same. If things continue to remain on track, we are likely to see Apple's new iPhones in September this year. The company is rumored to launch 4 new iPhone models. These include an iPhone 13, 13 mini, 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max. According to the new report, Apple is likely to unveil the 2021 iPhone lineup on September 14th. Caviar is known for its patience. It is, however, known for creating luxury versions of smartphones covered with as many precious metals and precious stones as they can hold. The latest lineup has a cosmic theme and it comes from the future. The mentioned images are just prototypes, but Caviar plans to customize iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max. A couple of these have enough meteoroids on them to make even Bruce Willis break a sweat. They are called as Parade of the Planets and are covered with a black and titanium, a material used in this space industry. The golden version also features a decorative elements with double gold plating, 99 gold and 7 micron thick, and starts from $14,290. The titanium model is a tad more affordable at $12,750. The Samsung and AMD are working together for a new chipset that features Team's RETS GPU. It seems that this chip might not be an exclusive to the South Korean tech giant. According to the leakster, a Chinese microblogging website, a new chipset that features AMD's RDNA 2 architecture might also ship with flagship smartphones from Vivo. This chip is rumored to be called as Exynos 2200, which will sport processing components from Samsung and the graphical components from AMD to offer a more powerful processor. This chipset is rumored to ship with next generation flagship from South Korean firm and even certain laptops as well. Qualcomm is planning to build a new Snapdragon 888 chipset without the 5G connectivity. It will be a new platform with a model number SM8450. It will be aimed at manufacturers who prefer to sell in markets where the next generation networks have not been developed and one particular maker that is not allowed to use 5G technology from American companies. Yes, we are talking about Huawei. According to some leaksters, the P50 series scheduled to launch in late July will be powered by this new Qualcomm chipset. South Korean company Samsung has offered another version of smartphone with a flexible display. This time we are talking about the device with a body stretching across the width. According to the reports, the information about the new product was published on the website of United States Patent and Trademark Office, as well as we can also see in the database of the World Intellectual Property Organization. When folded, the device resembles a traditional all-in-one smartphone. If necessary, the user can expand the case, transforming the device into a small tablet. At the same time, the flexible display twisted handle will increase in area by about a third. A feature of the device is a front camera under the screen. A fingerprint scanner is also present under the display area. In the back of the smartphone, you can see a triple main camera. Among other things mentioned are stereo speakers and a USB Type-C port. Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition have received TUV Rainland certification. The phone bears the model number M2012K10C and M2012K10I. Redmi K40 Gaming Edition will be rebranded as Poco F3 GT in India. OnePlus 9 series smartphones comes with the company's new retail box that is designed to be a bit bigger in terms of length. While the packaging looks decent, there is also an alternative packaging as revealed by OnePlus CEO Pat Liu. Pat Liu has shared an image on Twitter showcasing an alternative packaging of the OnePlus 9 series. However, it is not yet clear if the company had ever considered using that or if it is plans to do going forward. Xiaomi is expected to unveil MIUI 13, the next major version of its mobile operating system, very soon. Ahead of that, the company recently established MIUI Pioneer Group to iron out the bugs. Further, the firmware has started updating the system apps for MIUI 13. One such update for an application gives us a first glimpse of the upcoming UI. Micromax Int 2B has shown up on Geekbench running entry-level hardware. The device managed to net a single-core score of 250 and a multi-core score of 1204 on benchmarking platform. Its key specifications include a Unisoc T610 chipset and a 4GB of RAM and runs on Android 11. AMD today released its Fidelity FX Super Resolution or FSR. Announced earlier this month, FSR aims to render a high-resolution output image from a low-resolution source, thereby providing performance improvement without significant impact to image quality. Starting today, the feature is available in 7 titles including 22 Racing Series, Anno 1800, Evil Genius 2, Godfall, King's Hunt, and Terminator Resistance and the Riftbreaker. AMD has announced that the feature is also coming to Dota 2, Far Cry 6, and Resident Evil Village by this end of this year. The company claims that more than 40 game developers have pledged to support this feature. Grafton admits Battlegrounds Mobile India have been communicating with servers in China. It assures that the issue would be addressed before the game officially launches in India. Grafton says that it has not violated any guidelines mentioned in the privacy policy. Battlegrounds Mobile India is the talk of the town, especially among gamers. While the game was already open for pre-registration and for beta testing for Android smartphones, there was no talk of its availability on the iPhone. Until now, Battlegrounds Mobile India for iOS is likely to arrive on the Apple App Store in the coming days. In a tragic incident, the two boys died yesterday after falling off a boat in a pond while playing PUBG online game. This incident is happened on Assam. After some time, the local people recovered them and sent them to the nearby healthcare center where they were declared brought dead. Facebook's alternative to Clubhouse has started rolling out in the US to some iOS users. It is called as Live Audio Rooms and also come with podcast. Both features are a part of the Facebook platform and for now are limited to just selected public figures and groups. iQ3 price in India has been officially slashed by over 50% by the company. The smartphone is listed for a jaw-dropping starting price of ₹17,495 on its official website, a discount of over ₹20,000 over its asking price of ₹37,990. The price for the iQ3 base variant with 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. As the 8GB RAM and 256GB storage and a 12GB RAM and a 256GB storage variants are also on sale. It is an excellent deal as one gets a powerful Snapdragon 865 chipset for less than ₹20,000. However, the offer is limited to the 4G variant of the phone. Honor is proudly going forward as an independent company, and last week we saw the first flagship series since the company is separated from Huawei. It is also moving towards the foldable devices after patenting at least 3 names: Magic Flip, Magic Fold, and Magic Flex. The trade name does not necessarily mean Huawei will launch 3 phones, nor they give a specific timeline of an potential foldable arrival. A couple of leaks that surfaced revealed the existence of high-end techno phone named Phantom X. Today, Techno Mobile's African divisions such as Ivory Coast, Republic of Congo, and Ghana have started teasing the arrival of the smartphone. One of the listings shows that the handset is up for pre-order starting from today. Vivo V21e 5G price in India has been revealed ahead of the launch tomorrow. The price in India will be for ₹24,990. The key specifications include a 6.44-inch AMOLED display, MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor and a 64-megapixel dual rear camera and a 4000mAh battery. Itel to launch smart TV 4K range in India next month. It is expected to bring a 55-inch model and it will have an ultra-bright display, 4K resolution, 24-watt speakers and it run on Android TV OS. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.